Hello viewer, welcome to the Science Hub. I am Vincent Ngathis and my colleague here.
And I am Ian Mwendwa.
Today we are going to discuss the topic of quadratic equations and expression. When we say quadratic equation and expression, what do you understand by the term quadratic equation? A quadratic equation is any equation whose highest power of the unknown is 2. What do I mean? For example, when you are given an equation in form of ax square plus bx plus z, this one qualifies to be called a quadratic expression simply because highest power of the unknown is 2. But take for example, when you do are given an equation in form of ax plus bx plus z, this one does not qualify to be called a quadratic expression simply because the highest power of the unknown is 1. And as we have known, the highest power of the quadratic expression, highest power is 2. This one does not qualify. At times, you get an equation. For example, 8x squared plus 2x plus 3. This one is a quadratic expression. The highest power of the unknown is 2. Whereby we have the equation. In this equation, we have 8 being the coefficient of x squared. 2. We have 2 being the coefficient of x, and we have 3 here being the constant term. Mark my words. The coefficient of x squared should not be equal to 0. The coefficient of x squared, that is a, should not be equal to 0.
Another example where a situation where b is absent. 2x squared plus 3. 2 here is the coefficient of x. And in reference to this equation, a is the coefficient of x squared. So a here will be 2. X here is missing. So we assume, we make an assumption that this equation is like this. 2x squared plus 0x plus 3. Where now b will be 0. Now, see in this equation, 3 will be represented by letter c. So in reference to this equation, ax squared plus bx squared plus c, 3 here is a constant, and a constant is represented in this equation by c. So c here will be is equals to 3.
Also, when we as from the example we have seen that in this first example we have been given the part of b is missing, and also you can get there's also sometimes you find whereby z is missing. Here we have b missing. For example, you have been given an equation, maybe 2x squared plus 3x. Here we have 3x here, but we lack the part of z. In this situation, when you have been given such an equation, hereby you assume that here is plus 0, and then you will have your coefficient. That's the coefficient of a being 2, and the coefficient of b, that's the coefficient of x, I mean coefficient of a of x to be 3, and the coefficient of the constant term that is c should be 0.
So to see factorization means is writing a quadratic expression as a product of two linear binomials. For example, x squared plus 7x plus 12. So first of all, when factorizing, the factors should be in pairs. Here we can see the factors are not in pairs, that is in binomial expressions. So we make them to be in pairs. and the number which is affected when making them be in pairs is 7. Next. This, during making them be in pairs, we take the product S A times C and sum S B. This A times C and B comes from the form in which expression, a quadratic expression is presented. That is AX squared plus BX plus C. So here our product will be 12 times 1. That is 12. Our sum will be 7. So then you ask yourself, which number when you multiply will give you 12, and when you do its sum will give you 7?
3 and 4.
That is 3 and 4. And when writing these numbers, you should look at the signs. So here it is plus. So it means the numbers
should be positive.
So you replace 7 with 3x and 4x. So x squared plus 3x plus 4x plus 12. Then you factorize. So it is x into brackets x plus 3. Since in factorization, the group in grouping, the binomial expression in both expression are the same. You just write here x plus 3, and then you look which factor is same here. So it is 4, and you look this sign and this sign, so it is plus. So for it to remain plus when you open, here it is plus. So the binomial expression will be x plus 4, and you take one of them here, so it is x plus 4 plus 3 again. Sorry.
Here again, this one will also help us to solve real life situations examples. This quadratic equation will also help us to solve real life examples. For example, you can be told Sharon's rectangular room measures is in rectangular form, and you are told that Sharon's rectangular room measures 4 meters longer than its wide. 4 meters than its wide. This is the length and this is the width. So you are told that it measures 4 meters than its wide. Take for example, call here x, and then you have been told 4 meters longer than it is wide, meaning this 4 meters longer than its wide. So it would be 4 plus x. Then you are told the area of this rectangle is, it is equal to 12 meters square. Then you are told find the value of x. The value of x, how do you find the area of the rectangle? Area of the rectangle is equal to length times width, whereby you say length, that's 4 plus x, you multiply by x. So you say x times 4, and then you equate with 12, whereby you have 12 meters square. X times 4, it will give you 4x. X times x, it will give you x square plus is equal to 12. So here you take 12 to the other side. When you take to the other side, it will become 4x plus x square minus 12 is equal to 0. Here you find the value of x. Here, for it to be simple, you have to rearrange it in form of x square plus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0. According to the factorization whereby you have been told here, you have to factorize this one first. And the way you factorize this one, you say you find a product. Which numbers, when you find their product, it will give you, that's 1 times 12. 1 is the coefficient of x square. That's 1 times negative 12. It will give you, so product is equal to 1 times negative 12, it will be negative 12. And then sum is equal to 4. Which numbers do you, when you multiply, it will give you negative 12? And when you find their sum, it will give you 4. Sum, it will be, find the product, it will give you this one, sum, it will give you this one. These numbers will be 6 and 2. And when you take, you have to, the other one to be negative and the other one to be positive. Because here we will take negative 2 to be, this one to be negative. So that will give us the correct format. When you come there, here we have got that the products should be 6 and negative 2. Those are the numbers that when you multiply it will give you negative 12. So you will take these numbers and substitute it in form of x square here. So it will be x square plus 6x minus 2x, and then you minus 12 there. Minus 12, it will give us 12, it will give us 0. Here we have the value to be 0. When you come here, you have to group them into pairs of 2. So here, what's common here? What's common here is x into x plus 6. Here, we have the common value to be negative 2 into x plus 6 is equal to 0. Big one from the brackets. Those units that are in brackets because they are similar. So here, we'll take x minus 2 into x plus 6 is equal to 0. This means this in these brackets will give us 0, and this ones in this bracket will give us 0, whereby you will have to get a value of x. So we use the first bracket, that's x minus 2 is equal to 0. When you take to the other side, you will get x to be 2, and then from this bracket you will be able to get x plus 6 is equal to 0. Now when you take 6 to the other side, it will become negative, so it will become x is equal to negative 6. So we have the values of x to be 2 and negative 6. But in real life situation, there is no negative length. So we'll take the positive length. So x to be 2. The length of the triangle here, you will come and substitute if you want to find the length of the rectangle. So here will be 2 meters. And here will be x plus 4. That's 2 plus 4, it will be 2 times 6, if you will get the area. That is it.
Up to there, we have come to the end of our discussion on science app. I was yours, Ian Mwendo.
And I am Vincent. Keep it the Limo TV, where we watch and learn.